स्वेच्छा केसरिणः स्वच्छस्वच्छाय आयासित इन्दवः त्रायन्ताम्बो मधुरिपोः प्रपन्नार्थि छिदो नकाः. सो वी आर लुकिङ्ग् एट् एक्साम्पल्स् आफ् शब्दशक्तिमूलध्वनि. यत्र तु सामर्थ्याक्षिप्सं सत् अलङ्कारान्तरं शब्दशक्त्या प्रकाशते स सर्वः एव ध्वनेः विषयः. वि लुक्ड् एट् हौ इट् इस् डिफ़रेण्ट् फ्रम् श्लेष. नौ हि स्टार्टेड् गिविङ्ग् एक्साम्पल्स् फार् शब्दशक्तिमूलम्. सो शब्दशक्त्या यत्र अलङ्कारान्तरं सामर्थ्याक्षिप्तं सत् वेन् इट् इस् बै द फोर्स् आफ् द वर्ड्स् बै द पवर् आफ् द वर्ड् शब्दशक्त्या अलङ्कारान्तरम् आक्षिप्तं सत् वेन् इट् इस् सजेस्टेड् देन् इट् इस् ध्वनिर्विषयः. इन् दिस् एक्साम्पल् ऐ मेड् अ मिस्टेक् ऐ थाट् दट् शरच्च अण्ड् ग्रीष्मश्च इस् देर् इन् चमकं बट् इट्स् आक्चुलि ऋतुश्च मे इस् देर् सो बै वे आफ् दट् एव्रि ऋतु इस् अ नाम आफ् शिव सो ऐ जस्ट् वाण्टेड् टु पायिण्ट् दट् औट् सो ग्रीष्माभिधानः एस् सच् इस् नाट् अ डबल् मीनिङ्ग् वेर् इट् इस् रेप्रसेण्ट् इट् इट् गिव्स् द मीनिङ्ग् आफ् महाकाल आल्सो शिवपक्षे वक्तुं न शक्यते. But it is only the Ritu that is the Prakritam for you. So when the Prasangam or the context fixes the meaning in a particular, for a particular object, and if there is another object that is suggested, then it is Shabda Shakti Moolatvani. We also looked at this example where there is an Upamyam. Now we are looking, another example for Upama Dhvani is from Mayura Shatakam. मयूरकवि सूर्यशतकं दत्तानन्दाः प्रजानां समुचितसमयाकृष्टसृष्टैः पयोभिः पूर्वाह्णे विप्रकीर्णा दिशि दिशि विरमत्यह्नि संहारभाजः दीप्तांशोर्दीर्घदुःखप्रभवभवभयोदन्वत् उद उत्तारनावः गावः वः पावनानां परमपरिमितां प्रीतिमुत्पादयन्तु वः पावनानां वः परम् अपरिमितां प्रीतिं गावः उत्पादयन्तु दीप्तांशोः गावः दीप्तांशोः यस्य अंशवः दीप्तियुक्ताः सन्ति सः सूर्यः सो दीप्तांशोः सूर्यस्य गावः किरणाः and we know the context here so he is describing the surya and he is describing the surya kirana here so gavaha the meaning of gavaha even though the first meaning that arises because of our vocabulary the limited vocabulary that we have the moment we hear the word gavaha we think it is gau gavo gavaha and it is a indicative of dhenu cow correct we don't think of the word kiranam in our mind But looking at the context, Deeptamshoho Gavaha ityukte Deeptamshoho Kiranaha Eva Tatra Prakrita Varnana Anusarena. Then we can fix the meaning of Gavaha as Kiranam. So one meaning will be for Kiranam, the other meaning is going to be for Dhenu, Dhenu Pakshe Api Vartate. The first we will look at the Prakritam meaning and then only we can go to the Dhvani. And then the Upamadhvani, okay? So, Gavaha, Deeptamshoho Gavaha, Suryasya Kiranaha, Vaha, Pavananam Vaha, Aparimitam Preetim, Param Aparimitam Preetim Utpadayantu. Let it give joy, an unlimited joy to all of you people who are Pavana, who are very pure. Pavananam Vaha Preetim Utpadayantu. दत्ता प्रजानां दत्तानन्दाः दोस् गावः इट्स् एन् एड्जेक्टिव् टु द किरणं सो किरणपक्षे समुचित समय आकृष्ट सृष्टैः पयोभिः नो फस्ट् वन् इस् प्रजानां दत्त आनन्दाः दे गिव् जाय् टु आल् क्रीचर्स् प्रजानां दत्त आनन्दाः किरणाः So the rays of sun's rays gives happiness to everybody. The moment the sun rises, we are all feeling energized and we start doing our work. It gives us that utsaha. As night falls, we are looking forward to going and sleeping and resting. So this one gives a joy to everybody that we can start doing some work. There is no lethargy in our mind. So prajanam datta anandaha. जनेभ्यः सर्वजनेभ्यः सर्वप्राणिभ्यः आनन्दं ददाति किरणं नेक्स्ट इज समुचित समय आकृष्ट सृष्टैः पयोभिः. वाई इट गिव्स आनंदम इज इट गिव्स आनंदम बाय टेकिंग एंड रिलीजिंग द वाटर. सो समुचित समये एट द करेक्ट टाइम ड्यूरिंग ग्रीष्म ऋतु इट टेक्स द वाटर आकृष्टम जलम. वर्षाकाले समुचित समये वर्षाकाले सृष्टैः पयोभिः इट कन्वर्ट्स इट एंड इट क्रिएट्स वाटर एंड ड्यूरिंग द रेनी सीजन इट गिव्स वाटर फॉर पीपल. सो तेन अपि प्रजानां दत्त आनन्दाः. इवन विद द जलम दट इट क्रिएट्स ड्यूरिंग द वर्षा सीजन इट गिव्स आनंदम. ओके सो समुचित समय आकृष्ट समुचित समय उत्सृष्ट पयोभिः प्रजानाम आनंदम ददति. दीप्तांशोः किरणाः. नेक्स्ट वन इज पूर्वाह्ने विप्रकीर्णाः दिशि दिशि. पूर्वाह्ने इन द मॉर्निंग टाइम इट स्प्रेड्स इट्स द किरणम इट इज स्कैटर्ड इन ऑल डायरेक्शंस ड्यूरिंग द मॉर्निंग एंड देन अन्ही विरमति सति व्हेन द एट द क्लोज ऑफ द डे व्हेन द डे completes viramati sati samhara bajaha all the kiranam it becomes disappear or it just gathers. I can't say it gathers, the gathering part is only for gavaha, for the dhenu paksham. So samhara bajaha means it becomes samakshiptaha, it becomes sankuchitaha bhavanti kiranaha or they disappear. Samhara bajaha kiranaha deeptamshoho kiranaha. Another adjective for that is dirgha dukkha प्रभव भव भय उदन्वत उत्तार नावः. सूर्य किरणम इज लाइक एन उत्तार नाव. इट इज लाइक अ शिप. नावः दे आर लाइक शिप्स विच हेल्प यू उत्तार टू क्रॉस दिस ओशन. भव भयम उदन्वत. उदन्वत इज एन ओशन विच इज दिस ट्रांसमाइग्रेटरी एग्जिस्टेंस दैट वी हैव. Janma, punarjanma, janma, maranam, punarjanma, maranam. This non-ending cycle of janma and punarjanma, that ocean, we can cross that ocean with the help of the Surya's rays. Because if you read Aditya Hridayam, you'll know. Surya is talked about as the Paranjyotishe, Paranjyotihi. He is the Parabrahma Swarupam. So in order to cross this ocean, which is Bhava Bhaya, the fear that is associated with this world, Bhava Bhaya is not exactly fear. There is so much of Advaita references to this. There is a totally different meaning for these things. So Dirgha Dukkha Prabhava. There is a long dukkham that we have because of this existence, janma and punarjanma. We don't know how many janmas we have crossed. We don't know how many janmas we are going to take. That is why it is called the dirgha dukkham. This shariram is associated with dirgha dukkham. And from that, because of that, this existence seems like an ocean which has to be crossed. For that, we need a ship. What is the ship? गावः. दीप्तांशोः गावः. सूर्यस्य किरणाः ये दीर्घदुःखेन प्रभव भव भय नाम उदन्वत् समुद्रस्य उत्तारनावैव सन्ति. वः पावनानां वः परम् अपरिमितां प्रीतिम् उत्पादयन्तु. नौ दिस् गावः वर्ड् हेज़् टु मीनिङ्ग्स्. इट् आल्सो मीन्स् धेनु. धेनुपक्षे हौ डु वि एक्स्प्लेन् इट्? प्रजानां समुचित समय आकृष्ट सृष्टैः पयोभिः एट द करेक्ट टाइम इट टेक्स इट गिव्स मिल्क. इट टेक्स इन फूड एट द करेक्ट टाइम एंड एट द प्रॉपर टाइम व्हेन द काव्स नीड द मिल्क इट सृष्टि इट क्रिएट्स द मिल्क फॉर द काव्स विच इज प्रजा. स्वस्य प्रजानां कृते स्वस्य वत्सानां कृते दत्त आनन्दाः गावः धेनवः. So it gives happiness to the all the calves by providing milk at the correct time. Purvanne viprakirnaha dishi dishi, for grazing the host of all the herd of cattle just spreads everywhere. It is scattered in all directions during the morning. And anhi viramati sati samhara vajaha, the cowherd calls all the cows together and gathers it around to put it in the pen. Right, in the cattle shed. So dirgha dukkha prabhava इट दैट वोंट अप्लाई टू गावः या जस्ट लाइक हाउ इन ग्रीष्माभिधान एवरीथिंग डिड नॉट अपियर ओनली दैट ग्रीष्माभिधान डिड नॉट अपियर दीज टू will appear, will fit perfectly. The first two lines will fit perfectly for both the Kiranam and the Dhenu Paksha. So that is the Shabda Shakti Moolam. So by the because the context is Surya Varnanam, the Abhida Shakti is fixed with the Kiranam and the Dhenu Paksha Artham is your suggested meaning and the Dhvani here is Vachyartha Vyangyartha Yoho Aupamyam. Just like how the cows behave, it is in the same way the Surya's rays are also present. So it helps us. Let it give you immense happiness. So here that Aupama Dhvani is your Shabda Shakti Moolam. It is based on the word Gavaha. It's just one word can contribute to that meaning. Eshu udaharaneshu. Eshu udaharaneshu Shabda Shaktya. One minute. Eshu. एषु उदाहरणेषु शब्दशक्त्या प्रकाशमाने सति अप्राकरणिके अर्थान्तरे सो अप्राकरणिके अर्थान्तरे वेन् द नान् कॉन्टेक्स्टुअल मीनिंग आउट ऑफ कॉन्टेक्स्ट मीनिंग प्रकाशमाने सति शब्दशक्त्या प्रकाशमाने सति एषु उदाहरणेषु इन ऑल द अर्लियर एग्जांपल्स राइट फ्रॉम दैट ग्रीष्म अत्रांतरे कुसुम समय उन्नत पुरोलस धारः एंड दत्तानंद प्रजाः इन ऑल दीस थ्री you have aprakaranike arthantare prakashamane sati vakyasya asambaddha artha abhidayitvam ma prasankshit. You should not think that there is an asambaddha artha, there is something unconnected meaning is being said. It does not have to be that the see what he is saying is how do I explain this? Vakyasya asambaddhartha abhidayitvam ma prasankshiditi aprakaranika prakaranikartha. So you have your vachyartham, your primary meaning, which is Surya Kirana. There is a vyangyartha, which is by the force of that word gauhu or gavaha, we get the meaning of denupakshe, we get a several meaning there. But if you do not think that this vachyartham and vyangyartham, the vyangyartham is asambandhartha. There is no connection to the vachyartham at all. See, why should we suddenly think about the cows? There is no sense here. It doesn't make sense at all. We are describing the context as Surya Kirana. The meaning should stop with Surya Kirana. If another meaning comes about, it has no connection with the present vachyartham, then it will be vyartham. There is no point in it. Because of that, upamana upameya bhavaha kalpayitavyaha samarthyat samarthyat vyanjana samarthyat we bring about that meaning. So aprakaranika prakaranika arthayoho aprakaranika out of context meaning prakaranika artha contextual meaning we bring about an upamana upameya bhavaha kalpayitavyaha samarthyat kasi samarthyat vyanjana vyaparasya samarthyat vyanjana vyaparaha atra vidyate tat samarthyat प्राकरणिकार्थ अप्राकरणिकार्थ द्वयोरपि अप्राकरणिकार्थस्य असंबद्धार्थत्वं स्यात् अन्यथा इफ वी डू नॉट ब्रिंग अबाउट एन उपमेय उपमान भाव उपमान उपमेय भाव देन द अप्राकरणिकार्थ आउट ऑफ कॉन्टेक्स्ट मीनिंग वुड बी एन असंबद्धम दैट इज इट इज अ टोटली अनकनेक्टेड मीनिंग इट इज नॉट रिलेवेंट टू द टेक्स्ट इज व्हाट वी विल फील बट इट शोज द ब्यूटी ऑफ द ब्यूटी इज ब्रॉट आउट व्हेन वी ब्रिंग अबाउट दैट उपमान उपमेय भाव कल्पितः अर्थ आक्षिप्तः अयं श्लेषः न शब्द उपरूढः इति विभिन्न एव श्लेषात् अनुस्वान उपम व्यंग्यस्य ध्वनेः विषयः. He says it is अर्थ आक्षिप्तः. If the see अयं श्लेषः means the श्लेष for दत्तानन्दाः samuchita samaya payobihi and all of those words, the double meaning that we associate for that is only based on the artham, the meaning, and not the word. Praja means vatsa also. It is just subjects. For a dhenu it is vatsa, for kiranam, for surya It is the all prani. That is an arthaslesha. It is not a shabdaslesha. Whereas only the word gavaha is shabdaslesha. But that shabda upa, that shabda contributes to the slesha for the rest of the shloka. And the rest of the shloka's slesha is only based on the meaning and not based on the word. Any other word can be given there. Right? So arthakshiptaha ayam slesha na shabda uparudaha iti vibhinnayeva slesha anuswana upamavyangyasya dvanehe vishayaha. So it is different from slesha. That is shabdashati muladvani is different from slesha. Now what are the prakaranika artha niyamakaha? I just mentioned that for ease of understanding. Samyogo viprayogascha sahacharyam virodhita artha artha prakaranam lingam shabdasya anyasya sannidhihi samarthyam auchiti deshaha kalaha vyaktihi swaradayaha shabdarthasya anavachede vishesha smriti hetavaha. These are all the smriti hetavaha. These are all the reasons with which we fix the context or fix the abhidha shakti, abhidha meaning, vachyartha for a shlokam. And then any other meaning that arises is your vyangyartha or a suggested meaning. Okay. Now, just because, Anandavardhana has mentioned upamana upameya bhava, any other alankara based on upamana upameya bhava can also be suggested. It is not only upama alankara that is a dhvani. You can have virodha dhvani, vyatireka dhvani. So, Lochanam explains it as tena upama rupena vyatirechana ninnavadayaha vyapara matra rupaha eva. You can have apannuti alankaram, you can have vyatireka alankaram. Any of these alankara, the moolam, the pradhanam, the important part there is aswada pratitehe pradhanam vishranti sthanam. Natu upameyadi iti sarvatra alankara dvanam mantavyam. It is not the upameyam or the upamanam is your dvani. Vyangyartham is the upamanam. Upameyam, that which has to be described, is your prakritam. So the aprakarnikartha becomes the upamanam. Upameyam is not your vishranti sthanam. You should not keep coming back and looking at, oh, he has described Surya Kirana so beautifully. The aswadam lies in the fact that he has been able to give us the image of cows, which is spread out in the morning, purvanne vikirati, and then viramati anhi samhara vajaha. He is able to beautifully bring about that image of gauhu and compare it with kirana and say that these two are sadrisham. That is where the aswadam is your important aspect here. What the sahrdaya can enjoy from the shloka is much more important than the upameyam that is explained in the shloka. Yeah. Now he goes to virodhidvani. Anyepicha alankaraha shabdashakti moola anuswana rupa vyengye dvanau sambhavantyeva tathahi virodho api shabdashakti moola anuswana rupaha drishyate yatha sthanvishwara akhya janapada varnane bhattabanasya. Anyepi alankaraha, other alankaras can also be suggested as far as shabdashakti moola dvani is concerned. So sambhavantyeva, it happens, tathahi virodhaha api, virodhalankara can also happen. Yatha, in Bhattabana's Harshacharitam, Sthanvishwara is the name of janapada, country. It is the name of a country. So Sthanvishwara is actually Thaneshwar, which is in Kurukshetra. It is there is a Sthanvishwara alayam, temple in Kurukshetra. It's still there, Thaneshwar it's called. So Sthanvishwarakya Janapada Varnane, in that description, he says the whole passage is given in Diditi actually. Etracha Matanga Gaminyaha Shilavatyahacha Gauryaha Bibhava Ratahacha Shyamaha Padmaraginyahacha Davala Dvija Shuchi Vadanaha Madiramodi Shwasanahacha Pramadaha. Diditi, he says the whole paragraph is given actually, but Anandavardhana does not quote the whole paragraph. See, He gives the entire paragraph with the double meaning for both adjectives. So yatra yatra yasmin sthanvishwarakhe janapade pramadaha pramadaha the ladies akautukaha praudhascha. So these are all description of the ladies. So each adjective is a each word is an adjective for pramadaha. Matanga gaminyaha. The vachyartham, the literal meaning is gaja iva gacchanti, gaja gaminyaha. They have a very beautiful walk. See, they walk like elephants. Shilavatyaha cha. They are also of great character. They have a very good character. Now, the other meaning for this is matanga gaminyaha, matangana, shabarana prati gacchanti, abhisaranti. So, one who is an abhisarika cannot be a shilavati. One who enjoys Shabara, enters, going to hunters, cannot be Shilavatyaha. So that is the Virodhalankara, that is a Dvani. But the literal Vachyartham is Matanga, Gajaiva Gacchanti. That is the Virodh Pariharam, actually. Next is Vibhavarata, Gauriyaha, Chule.
Sorry, so ipa inge vandu Virodha Dvanam Pariyavasanama illa
எனக்கு
actually ரொம்ப இதுவா புரியல அந்த சப்த சக்தி மூல துவனில யூ செட் அந்த தேன உபமா ரூபேண அத்ர ஆஸ்வாத பிரதீதேய பிரதானம் விஷ்ராந்தி ஸ்தானம் நது உபமேயாத்
சோ உபமேயா இஸ் யுவர் வாச்யார்த்தம் தேர் சோ இஃப் தி உபமேயம் இஸ் யுவர் வாச்யார்த்தம் யூ டு நாட் ஷட் நாட் பீ ஸ்டக் அட் தட் தத்ர விஷ்ராந்தி ஸ்தானம் நாஸ்தி ஆஸ்வாத பிரதீதேய பிரதானம் கிம் அஸ்தி தத்ரைவ விஷ்ராந்தி ஸ்தானம் வர்த்ததே அது துவனி சர்வத்ர அலங்காரத்வனவும் விஷ்ராந்தி ஸ்தானம் சஹிருதய பிரதீதவ் சோ சஹிருதயனுக்கு வந்து எப்படி ஒரு ஆஸ்வாதம் இருக்கோ அது எங்க முடியறதோ அததான் நம்ம வந்து விஷ்ராந்தி ஸ்தானமா எடுத்துக்கணும் சோ ஈவன் இன் திஸ் விரோத அலங்காரம் விரோத பரிகாரம் இஸ் நாட் சோ சமத்காரம்
ஓகே சோ ஆஸ்வாதத்தோட விஷ்ராந்தி அண்ட் மேபி ஐ திங்க் அர்த்தபோதா வந்து வேற அர்த்தபோதான்றது வந்து பரிஹாரத்துல வந்து முடியணும்
ஆஸ்வாதா இஸ் தேர் இன் தி விரோதத்வனி
ஓகே ஓகே புரியுது
பிகாஸ் விரோத இஸ் நாட் எக்ஸ்பிரஸ்ட் ஹியர் அதுவே ஹி இஸ் கோயிங் டு கிவ் அனதர் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஃபார் விரோதத்வனி பிகாஸ் யூ ஃபைண்ட் தி வேர்ட் ச ஹியர் ச இஸ் லைக் மாதங்க காமின்யஹ அபி ஷீலவத்யஹ
ஓ Okay.
And the madri could be an expressed someone.
Somebody could argue that cha equals api. Okay.
Yes. If you argue that it is expressed, then there is another shlokam that he gives.
Okay.
So without the cha, it is beautiful. Matanga gaminyaha, shilavatyaha, gauryaha, vibhavarataha, shyamaha, padmaraginyaha. So adla gauryaha, vibhavarataha cha. Gauryaha is their... They're fair. You can't say they're fair, no? They're actually Shyamaha. So, Gauryaha means here, they put it all right. Gauri, no? What is the literal meaning of that? Na paathukave illaye. He doesn't give that meaning, la? Oru nimisham. Gauryaha means fair skin, but he is given as Parvatyaha. La? அது வந்து விபவரதாக்கு போயிடுறது சோ கௌரவர்ணாஹா தனே ரதாஹா இது பரிஹாரா சோ கௌரவர்ணாஹா தே கதம் கிருஷ்ணவர்ணாஹா அப்படி பவித்து அர்ஹந்தி தட் வில் நாட் ஒர்க் சோ தி நெக்ஸ்ட் அட்ஜெக்டிவ் இஸ் ஆக்சுவலி ஷியாமாஹா சோ யூ கான்ட் சே கௌரவர்ணாஹா மேபி தே ஆர் போத் கௌரவர்ணா அண்ட் இது ஷியாமாஹா ஐ டோன்ட் நோ So I think Gauryaha can be Pativrataha na eduthukalam. Yatha Parvati Pativrata tathaiva etaha api Pativratyaha. Appadi vana eduthukalam. Illa Pativrataha na eduthukalam. Gauryaha. விபவ ரதாகங்கிறது விபவேஷு ரதாக ஏ சம்பத்சு ரதாக தன ரதாக சந்தி விபவ பவ ரஹித சிவ ரஹித ஸ்தானே ரதாக தே லைக் பிளேசஸ் விச் டு நாட் ஹாவ் சிவா பட் ஹவு கேன் தே பி கௌரி தே ஹவு கேன் தே பி கால்ட் அஸ் பார்வதி ஹூ ஆர் பதிவிரதாக அண்ட் தே டோன்ட் லைக் அ பிளேஸ் வேர் தேர் பதி இஸ் நாட் பிரசன்ட் ஸோ தட் இஸ் த விரோத துவனி விச் இஸ் சஜஸ்டிட் Next is Shyamaha, the Krishna Varnaha, they are dark in complexion. Padmaraginyaha, Padmaraga Ragena Lauhityena Yuktaha. So Padmaraga Ratnam, they have a lot of wealth with them. So Vibhave Rataha, they like wealth. They have these gems, which are Padmaraga gems, a type of ruby, right? So they have rubies, yet they are dark in color, complexion. So the virodha dvani, that is the vyangyartham, is padmasya ragena, which is red in color. So they are both red in color and krishna varnaha, that will not fit, right? Next is davala dvija shuchi vadanaha. Davala dantaihi, davala dvija is the dvirjayate, the tooth also grows twice, once as a baby tooth and then the second as a permanent tooth. So dvija means teeth. Davala dvijaihi dantaihi shuchi vadanaha, their face is prakasha yuktam asti. Next, the other meaning for that is, and madira amoda shwasanaha, madira amodi shwasanaha, their breath has the fragrance of madira, of wine. So they drink wine, or they are probably very they naturally have that smell, fragrance in their breath. So madira modi shvasanaha. Now the other meaning for davala dvija shuchi vadanaha, utkrishta vipraha dvijaha, davala dvijaha, sreshtaha dvijaha, tasya vadanam yatha pavitram bhavati tatha pavitra vadanam. If you talk of a Brahmin who has a very pure mouth, because he says the Vedam, etc., he will not be drinking alcohol, liquor. So Madhira Modi and Dvija Vipravata Shuchi Vadanam do not go together. That is your Virodhadhuni. Okay. So Atrahi Vachyaha Virodhaha. Here Vachyaha Virodhaha Tachaya Anugrahiva Sleshaha Ayam Iti Nashakyam Vaktum. Sakshat Sabdena Shabdena Virodhalankarasya Aprakashitattvat. You cannot claim, the Purupakshi cannot claim and say that this is Virodhalankaraha, which uses Shleshaha as a Tachaya Anugrahi. So in order to understand Virodha, we use Shlesha, and Shlesha helps us in understanding the Virodha. You cannot say Iti Vaktum Nashakyate, that you cannot argue like that, because Sakshat Shabdena மாதங்ககாமின்யஹ அபி ஷீலவத்யஹ கௌர்யஹ அபி விபவ ரதாஹ பவ ரஹித சிவ ரஹித ஸ்தானே ரதாஹ இதி வக்தும் ந சக்யதே. There is no word that indicates the விரோதாலங்கார. யத்ர ஹி சாக்ஷாத் சப்த, as a பிரத்யுதாஹரணம் he gives another example, where யத்ர ஹி சாக்ஷாத் சப்த ஆவேதிதஹ விரோதாலங்காரஹ தத்ரஹி ஸ்லிஷ்டோக்தௌ வாச்யாலங்காரஸ்ய விரோதஸ்ய ஸ்லேஷஸ்ய வா விஷயத்வம் யதா தத்ரைவ. இன் தி சேம் ஹர்ஷசரிதம் சமவாயைவ விரோதினாம் பதார்த்தானாம், விரோதினாம் பதார்த்தானாம், the objects which are mutually contradictory in nature, it is as if there is a samavaya, there is a connection, or the both padartham, the vastus which are all contradictory in nature, seem to exist together, coexist in one place. That is the Purvapitika he starts with, and he gives a set of objects which are contradictory in nature but exist at the same time, further describing the same thing. Okay, so yatra hi sakshat shabdavedita virodhalankaraha, when the virodhalankara is being mentioned explicitly with a word, like here virodinam samavayaha eva, it is as if contradictory objects are coexisting, that itself shows that that virodha has been expressed clearly in the following sentences. Tatra slishtoktau, when there is a slesha associated there, then virodhalankara vachyalankarasya virodhasya slesha, the vachyalankara, the expressed alankara in such cases is either virodhalankara or slesha, or there is a sankara. You can say whichever, depending on whose follower you are. So yatha tatraiva samavayaiva virodhinam padarthanam, as an example he says tathahi sannihita balandhakarapi bhasvan murtihi. He is bhasvan murtihi, he has got a form which is prakasha yuktam, even though sannihita bala andhakara api. This is a description of Kadambari, I think. Balandhakara api, even though there is a bala, bala means hair, a dark hair, she has a dark locks of hair. So bala andhakara sannihita api, even though there is a andhakaram nearby, yet her form is bhaswat, it is prakasha yuktam. So andhakare sati prakashaha bhavitum narati, prakashe sati andhakaraha bhavitum narati. So then that is a contradiction in nature, but both of them exists there. Here it is virodhalankara is vachyam, it is not vyangyam, it is not a shabdashakti mulatvani. Ityado yatha yathava mamaiva, from this yathava mamaiva he gives an aparam udaharanam for shabdashakti mula virodhadvani. This the first two sentences are just for a pratyudaharanam to show where virodhalankara is vachyam and not vyangyam. For this, the next shlokam that he gives is a vyangyartham for us, virodhadvani. Cholima?
Sorry, sannihita bala andhakaraku enna pariharam chatten purila.
Adhudhaan bala andhakaram na, bala is hair, kesha. Keshasya andhakaraha asti, parantu murtihi, the form is prakasha yuktam asti. Only just her kesha pasham is very dark and ghanam. She's got thick locks, but her form is prakasha.
Appa virodham edha actually enak adu purila.
Virodham is andhakaram, andhakare sati bhasvan eppadi irukka mudiyum, suryaha katham bhavitum arhati.
Okay, vero, okay, avladha, okay,
avladha,
sari.
There is romba slesha kadaiyadhu idhula, yeah. So yathava mamaiva, this is so complicated, the shlokam, so I had to write it like this. Each word has double meaning and there is a virodham there. So sarvaika sharanam akshayam adhisham isham diyam harim krishnam chaturatmanam nishkriyam arimathanam namatha chakradharam. Namatha, all of you, let offer your salutation to that Hari, Vishnu. Yaha chakradharaha. So there are several adjectives for him. So what is the first one? Sarvaika sharanaha. He is the eka sharanaha for everybody. He is the eka raksha, rakshita for everybody. Akshayam, who nasha rahitaha saha. Adhishaha, he is the overlord for everybody. Dhyam ishaha, he is also the controller of the mind or buddhi. Buddhi vikaranam sarvatra yatra layaha, yatra layam gacchati. That is the he is the enna solradhu ashrayam for all the vikaram, where your you cannot understand him through your buddhi. So dhyam api ishaha saha. Harihi, he is Vishnu. Krishnaha, krishnakhyaha, krishna avataraha. Chaturatmanam, chaturatmanam means chatura chatvaraha atma murti swarupaha. He has four vyuharupam, which is Krishna, Balarama, Aniruddha and Pradyumna. So chaturatmanam, whose form is can be divided into four. Nishkriyam, kriya rahitaha, paramatma swarupaha tasmat kriya rahitaha. Arimathanam, arimathanam shatru nashakaha saha. Chakradharam, ye haste sudarshana chakram dharati. Tadrisham devam namata, bow to him. So each one is now giving us a virodhalankaram. Now none, you don't have sarvaika sharanam api akshayam, athava sarvaika sharanam akshayam cha. There is no api, no cha for us to even say that virodhalankara is expressed here. is primary meaning, is vachyam here. It is actually lingam. When you look at the double meaning, second meaning. So what is the second meaning? Sarvesham ekam sharanam. Sayeva griham. Sarvesham ekam sharanam means he is one house. He is a house. Then akshayam means kshayaha is also griham. One who is not a house. So one who is a house, or one who is not, who does not have a house. Akshayaha, you can also say, yasya griham nasti. Right? Adhishaha. Dhyam ishaha na iti adhishaha. Dhyam ishaha dhishaha. Buddhinam ishaha. He is the controller of all your thoughts or buddhi. But he is not a controller of your buddhi. That is the slesha meaning that we get as a vengya. So adhishaha dhyam ishaha. How can a person who is the controller of buddhi also not be the controller of the buddhi? Harihi haritavarnaha, krishnaha krishnavarnaha. So both are contradictory again. Chaturatma, one who is clever. Chaturaha, chaturaha means one who is clever, is not just intelligent. Clever means he is skillful. Skillful involves some action. One who is skillful can never be nishkriyaha. Kriya rahitaha api asti. How can we say that? Right? Arimathanaha, ari, ara, arani asya iti ari, chakram. Chakra nashakaha, mathanaha, nasha, he destroys the chakram. At the same time, he also carries a chakra. Ari is something like how we say chakraha asya chakram asya asti iti chakri. In the same way, araha arani asya santi iti ari chakram. One who has the spokes.
So here arimathana means then it would be like araha yasya asti iti ari. So jivana chakram iti va katham.
No. Wheel spokes. Just a small one. The object that has the spokes. So he destroys the wheel, that's all.
Oh.
So if destroying the wheel of Janmam, that is also Vyangyam only. So, no, that is not Vyangyam. You can't say Vyangyam. Here it is actually Arimathana is the literal meaning is Shatrunashakaha.
Oh.
Appadi solrala.
Adhu vere Arthi Vyanjana, the Adutha chapter.
Aama. Yeah, that is the Arthashakti Udbhavam, that is. That is not Shabdashakti Mulam. You can have a combination of two dhvanis also, right?
Yeah.
So let's not go into that meaning, then this Virodham will go off.
Oh, okay.
So for that Virodham, we need the meaning of Chakra Nashakaha and Chakra Dharakaha.
Okay.
Then only that Virodha will be highlighted.
Okay, I'm thinking too much maybe.
So, Sarvaika Sharanam, Akshayam. You understand the Virodha Dvani, right? The literal meaning is Sarvaika Sharanaha, Sarvesham, Ekaha, Sharanaha. Rakshita, Atava, Ashrayaha, Sayeva. And then Akshayaha, Nasharahitaha. So, the second meaning that I have given is your Vachyartham. The other meaning is where it is highlighting the Virodha that exists between the two, or the contradictory nature of two objects or two Visheshanam that exists in the same person, that coexists in the same person. So here it is a Virodha Vasa Dvani. Yeah. Virodha Alankara and Virodha Vasa Alankara are the same. Evam Vidaha Vyatirekaha Api Drishyate. The same way we also see Vyatireka Alankara. Yatha Mamaiva Anandavardhana's shloka. Kham ye atyujvalayanti luna tamasaha eva nakhodbhasinaha. ये पुष्णन्ति सरोरुह श्रियमपि क्षिप्ताब्ज भासश्च ये मूर्धसु अवभासिनः क्षितिभृतां ये च अमराणां शिरांसि आक्रामन्ति उभयेऽपि ते दिनपतेः पादाः श्रिये सन्तु वः दिनपतेः पादाः वः श्रिये सन्तु दिनपतेः उभये अपि पादाः दिनपतेः सूर्यस्य उभये अपि पादाः बोथ् टैप् आफ् फीट् Let both feet, both sets of feet, lead you to prosperity. Vaha shriye santu. Let it be for your prosperity. So, how are those two feet? What are the two feet he's talking about? Padaha, kiranaha, as well as charanaha. both are going to fit now. Okay, charanau and kiranaha. Now, kham ye ujvalayanti. One is luna tamasaha kiranaha. Those rays of the sun, they destroy the darkness. Luna tamasaha. Luna means cut away the darkness. So that which removes the darkness, by removing the darkness, it lights up the sky. Kham ujvalayanti. Kham akasham ujvalayanti prakashayanti. This is for kiranam. So in the first three lines, the first half is for kirana. The second half of the first padam, each padam is for the charana. So that is where the vyatirekam is going to come as a dhvani. So let's look at the vachyartham first. So kham ye charana kiranaha, kham ujvalayanti akasham ujvalayanti prakashayanti. By removing the darkness, it lights up the entire akasham. Yeva or those, the charanaha, the feet, nakha udbasinaha. They even their you know, the nails are enough to lighten up the entire world, or the toenails are shining. You can also say like that, nakaha udbasinaha santi yesha. It's for those charana, feet which have the toenails which are shining. So ye saroruha shriyam api pushnanti. Here the kiranam, surya kirana, suryasya kiranaha yada pankajani sprishanti, tada saroruhani, saroruhanam shriyam pushnanti. It nourishes the beauty of lotuses. It increases the lotus beauty. Which one? That is the kiranam, right? Next, those feet which put the beauty of lotuses to shame. Kshipta abja bhasaha. The charanam is pankaja iva asti, suryasya charanam. So they put the abjasya, you know, the beauty of the lotus is also are kshipta tiraskritaha bhavanti. Okay. Ye murdhasu kshitibhritam murdhasu avabhasinaha. Those kirana, the rays of the sun are shining on the top of the mountains. Kshitibhritam parvatanam murdhasu shikhareshu avabhasinaha prakashinaha prakab. They're shining on the top of the mountains. Next is yecha amaranam shiramsi akramanti. Those which overcome even the deva's heads. Amaranam api shiramsi. That is, they are shining even on top of the devas, on the heads of the devas. So Surya is an overlord for even the devas, because they say he is the Ishwara and he is the Parameshwara, Parabrahma Swarupa. So he can even rule the devas. So amaranam cha shiramsi ye akramanti te ubhaye api dinapatehe padaha. Both those sets of feet, let it lead you to prosperity. Shriye santu. Now let's look at the vyatireka dhvani here. Okay. Sarojam tattva dojane chetas chitram eke. Anihantavyam agirni vaseika chitro. Okay. I didn't think of that shlokam at all. No, I was so involved in this shlokam. Okay, so kham yeva apti ujvalayanti, kham ujvalayanti, yeva na kham ujvalayanti. Nakha udbasinaha will be kha udbasinaha ye na bhavanti. So the padaha are not better than, so the kiranam is better than pada. That is your vyatireka dhvani. Vyatireka is actually where upamana, upamana apekshaya upameyasya adhikyam yate varnyate tatra vyatireka alankaraha. Here the upamanam, we'll take the upamanam as Surya Charana, and Surya Kirana is the upameyam, because Dinapatehe Padaha is, he is talking of both. Actually, that Vyatirekam is only in Dvani. So we will take it as upameya, for example. And that upameyam is better. விகிரணம் இஸ் பெட்டர் தென் த சரணம் பிகாஸ் கிரணா இஸ் கேபபிள் ஆஃப் லைட்டிங் அப் தி ஆகாஷம் வேர் எஸ் சரணா இஸ் நாட் கேபபிள் ஆஃப் லைட்டிங் அப் தி ஆகாஷ ந க உத்பாசினா கம் ஏ ந உத்பாசயந்தி சரோருஹாணாம் ஸ்ரீயம் ஏ புஷ்ணந்தி த ரேஸ் நரிஷ் த பியூட்டி வேர் எஸ் ஹியர் க்ஷிப்தா மீன்ஸ் நாசயதி தி அதர் மீனிங் ஆஃப் தட் இஸ் நாசயதி ஏ அப்ஜ பாசம் நாசயந்தி சோ தட் இஸ் த டபுள் மீனிங் விச் கிவ்ஸ் ரைஸ் டு வியதிரேகம் ஹியர் இட் இஸ் க்ஷிதிபுஜாம் க்ஷிதிபிருதாம் மூர்தசோ அவபாசினஹ இட்ஸ் எ லிட்டில் பிட் டிஃபிகல்ட் அமராணாம் ஷிராம்சி ஆக்ராமந்தி ஹவு ஐ அண்டர்ஸ்டுட் தட் வியதிரேகம் நோபடி டிஸ்கிரைப்ஸ் திஸ் வியதிரேகம் ப்ராப்பர்லி இன் திஸ் லைன் So what I assume can be understood here is Surya's feet have tried to win over and akramanti means they step over and they have to physically step on the heads of the devas to show their supremacy whereas here the kiranam murdhaso avabhasinah anayasena ayatnena bhasante is what is the difference between the charanam and padam is what I feel otherwise I don't see if you look at this the kiranam actually only lights up the mountains whereas the feet is capable of even standing over the amara then the feet will become adhikam whereas we need the kiranam to be adhikam here that is where the vyatireka dvani is you can't have in two sentences kiranam is better than charana and then the third sentence the charana is better than the kiranam we can't have it like that so I was thinking we can probably explain it like that so amaranam shiramsi akramanti they have to walk or the feet have to show their supremacy in a more explicit way whereas here anayasena girina murdhasu avabhasante kam ye atyujjwalayanti luna tamasaha eva nakhodbasinaha ye pushnanti saroruha shriyamapi kriptabja bhasascha ye murdhasu avabhasinaha kshitibhrutam ye cha amaranam shiramsi akramanti ubhaye api te dinapatayehe pada shriye santu vaha evam anye api शब्दशक्तिमूल अनुस्वानरूप व्यंग्यध्वनि प्रकाराः सन्ति ते सहृदयैः स्वयं अनुसर्तव्याः देर् आर् मेनी अदर् एक्साम्पल्स् फार् शब्दशक्तिमूलध्वनि वेर् देर् केन् बि अलङ्कारध्वनि एण्ड् सहृदयैः स्वयम् अनुसर्तव्याः इफ् यु आर् अ कनाशियर् इफ् यु आर् एबल् टु अण्डर्स्टाण्ड् द शब्दशक्तिमूलध्वनि देन् यु विल् हेव् टु यूस् योर् बुद्धि वैशत्यम् एण्ड् ट्रै टु फैण्ड् इट् औट् இஹ து கிரந்த விஸ்தர பயாத் ந தத் பிரபஞ்சா கிருதா ஐ ஹவ் நாட் கிவன் எக்ஸ்பேண்டட் இட் ஃபர்தர் பை கிவிங் த ஆபன்னுதி அலங்கார விதிரேக எவ்ரி அதர் உபமா பேஸ்ட் அலங்கார இஃப் ஐ ஹாவ் டு கிவ் லைக் பிரதீப ரூபக எக்ஸெட்ரா எக்ஸெட்ரா தென் இட் வில் பிகம் கிரந்த விஸ்தர பயாத் த டெக்ஸ்ட் வில் பி நெவர் எண்டிங் ஸோ டு அவாய்ட் தட் ஐ ஹவ் ஸ்டாப்ட் வித் திஸ் So, Shabda Shakti Moolam finishes with this. The next is Artha Shakti Utbhava. Okay?